Hello friends, in this particular video lecture, we will try to understand an important part of network security which is known as X.509 format. So, understanding the structure of X.509, we require to understand the basic idea behind it. In the cryptography, X.509 is a standard defining the format of public key certificates. In the X.509 system, an organization that wants a signed certificate requests one via a certificate signing request. That is nothing but CSR. If you are going to understand the meaning of all these things, then you can verify the public key certificate algorithm. That means indirectly, while recognizing or authorizing each other in between the sender as well as receiver, we are required to do or use some authentication process such as Kerberos. And we already know the limitation of the Kerberos. So how can we do the other things which are able to authenticate the user if the certificate, or we can say the digital certificates, are there? Then the structure of X.509 will play an important role. How? That will try to verify a certificate with the help of CSR, certificate signing request. So only the authorized person is able to do the digital signature, that we already know, and that is used for the network security purpose. So if CSR will get sent or forwarded in between the user and the server, then that will become much more helpful for the process of the authentication. So how exactly that format will look like, that we will try to understand. So this is the basic structure of X.509. You can verify with the help of few process or the parameters, they are try to design the process. Here, there are some parameters such as version, service number, algorithm and parameter, issuer name, not before, not after, subject name, algorithm, parameter, key, issuer's unique ID, subject unique ID, extension, algorithm, parameter, encrypted hash. Such kind of lengthy parameters or number of huge parameters are present to do the authentication process. Now, here few parameters try to get combined in a one thing. For example, not before, not after. They are able to say them as a period of validity. Algorithm and parameter. Algorithm is a different thing and parameter is a different thing. They are going to combine that two things and it can represent with the help of signature algorithm identifier. This is the single name to algorithm and parameter. After that, algorithm parameter key. This can be known as the subject public key. And last one is algorithm parameter encrypted hash. This can be known as signature. Now we will try to understand how we can define the version. So, version can be defined as up to the subject public key, from this to this, that is known as version 1, V1. After that, when you try to add in V1 this particular issuer's unique ID and subject unique ID, then that will become V2. So how can I represent it? From version 2, subject unique ID, that will be V2, version 2. And last one is up to extension, from first, that is from version, up to extension, that will be the version 3. So the first block is there for version. So here you require to write down the number of version, whether the given application or the data will come under the V1, V2 or V3. So version 1 is able to provide you only up to this information. So if the information in your hand which is coming from the user, that is only up to the subject public key, then that will be in the version 1. For the version 2, you require these two more things. For version 3, you required extension also. And this is nothing but the signature, which is common for every version. So that is not going to show in any one of the version. So now we will try to understand the meaning of each and every block so that you can understand how can one is able to fill up all these blocks to verify the identity or to prove their identity. So version. It provides the information about V1, V2, V3, version 1, version 2, version 3. Second is service number. It is a unique number. This is the unique identity number. So how can we represent the number with the help of integer value of certificate? So this is the unique number which is having the integer value. Third one is signature algorithm, identifier. It is used to sign the certificate associated with parameters. Now, who will sign? Only the authorized user is able to sign. Next, issuer name. CA name, who have created and signed the certificate. So, CA means certificate authority. That particular organization or that particular person who have created and signed the certificate, his or her name should be there. Next one is period of validity. It shows the manufacture and expiry date. We have already seen not before, not after. That is nothing but what? The date in between which the certificate will be valid. So that is known as the period of validity. And that is very similar to that of the manufacture date and expiry date. So these are the few things which we have already seen whether they have stated in our particular structure of X.509. Now the next remaining things that are nothing but subject name. It can name the person or the organization. Extension. It is a set of one or more extension field. So extension can be the set of multiple extension field. Last one is signature. It covers all the fields of the certificates. So, if I want to verify the authorized user or the identity of the person or the user or the validity of the certificate, then how can I verify? With the help of version 1, version 2 or version 3. And for that purpose, the X.509 is able to provide us the structure which is able to prove the identity. Thank you.